into the earthworm. From there, the soil passes through this long green tube. In real life, it's not green, but this long green tube that I'm pointing to anyhow, until it gets to the crop. The crop is a pouch, a very thin pouch, sort of like a balloon, and it's designed to increase in size because that's where the soil is going to get stored until it makes it to the next phase of digestion called the gizzard. The gizzard is a very muscular organ, so if you push on it with a probe, you'll feel the resistance of all that muscle. And it's muscular because it digests and grinds the food. So the gizzard is going to do two things. It's going to release digestive enzymes, and it's going to grind the food up. It's going to mix the soil up with the small bits of organic material that this earthworm wants to digest. From there, we're going to go into the last part of the digestive tract, referred to as the intestine. Now, the intestine is probably going to make up 70-80% of the earthworm. And it's going to be that way for a reason, because we're trying to digest and absorb small bits of organic material mixed in with lots and lots of topsoil. So in order to do that, we have to create lots of surface area. And we're going to do that in two ways. One, we're going to have a very long intestine. And number two, if we look at a cross-section of the intestine, you'll see that right here we have an infolding of the intestine, and it forms a loop. And this loop is going to greatly increase the surface area in the intestine. You can see that if the tissue just came straight across, we would lose all that additional surface area for absorption. So this structure has a name. It's called the tiflosol. And its job is to increase the surface area for absorption. Now, let's take a look at the blood vessels. We're going to see three major blood vessels on this worm. The one blood vessel you can see right here is probably going to be the most prominent. It's going to be called the dorsal blood vessel. And its job is to return blood to the headward region. And then we can see some dilated blood vessels here on either side. And these dilated blood vessels are called hearts or aortic arches. And their job, they've been modified to pump blood. They are modified blood vessels, and that's exactly what a human heart is. It's a modified blood vessel, except it's become more modified and more specialized than the heart of an earthworm. Usually you'll have about five sets of these hearts. And if you're lucky, you'll see two or three on an actual dissection. If I turn this over, on the underside, the belly side of the earthworm, you'll see another blood vessel. And this is called the ventral blood vessel because it's on the ventral aspect. And this blood vessel actually returns blood back to the body of the earthworm. Along with that blood vessel runs a nerve. And you can see that nerve right here. It's a very large nerve, and we're going to call it the nerve cord. It's sort of analogous to your spinal cord. And that nerve cord is going to run the length of the earthworm. Now, at the most anterior aspect of the earthworm, up here, this nerve cord is going to form a large, at least with respect to the earthworm, a large focus of nerve tissue where nerve impulses actually get processed. This is called the brain right here. This is the brain. It's going to be very small in the earthworm, but if we see it, I'll point that out to you. Now, let me go ahead and put this back together again. And you can see two cream-colored organs on either side. These cream-colored organs are going to be called the seminal vesicles. And their job is to produce sperm, sperm that will be used to fertilize the eggs of another earthworm. And down here we have smaller structures, going to be similar in color, maybe a little bit whiter, but similar in color. And those are going to be your seminal receptacles. They call them receptacles because their job is to receive something. They actually receive the sperm of another earthworm. And they store that sperm temporarily until the earthworm is ready to fertilize its own eggs. Now, keeping with that thought, we've got another large prominent structure here on the external surface of the earthworm. You can see this band of tissue right here. And this is called the clitellum. And its job is actually to secrete like a viscous material that will eventually become the cocoon. And inside the cocoon will be the fertilized eggs. Now, also noted here, you can see these large flaps of skin right here. These are called septa, and they actually separate the internal part of the worm into compartments. So they are responsible for segmentation. The earthworm is not only segmented externally, but it's segmented internally also. And in each one of these compartments are different organs. Now the actual compartment here, all this space between the wall of the earthworm and the intestine or the digestive tract of the earthworm, is referred to as the coelom. And the coelom is broken up into segments by these septa. All right, let's go ahead and actually start the earthworm dissection.